Hello students, in this lesson let us discuss about the types of sleepers. So there are many types of sleepers, around six types. So in detail we'll see what each type is, what are the advantages of each type of sleeper as well as the disadvantages. So to get started with, the first type of sleeper division is based on the position in the railway track. How exactly the sleeper is laid in the railway track, based on that we have the classification. So based on position, so we have what? Longitudinal sleepers and transverse sleepers. It is very simple to understand. If your sleepers are in longitudinal direction, see here, this entire portion is your sleeper portion. If you observe, they are under the rail. They are under rail in the longitudinal position. So these type of sleepers are called as what? Longitudinal sleepers. When it comes to transfer sleepers, if you observe, the transfer sleepers are like this. They are perpendicular to the rail, right? In this case, they are parallel to rail and just below the rail, right? But when it comes to here, they are perpendicular to your rails. So normally, because they are laid in the transverse direction to the sleeper, they are called as transverse sleepers. Okay, so these type are the most common and the best type. Most common and the best type of sleepers are the transverse sleepers. Okay, so this was based on the classification of the position in which they are put in the railway track. The second one is based on the material that we use, right? The sleeper material what we use, based on that your sleepers are classified into three broad categories. That is the wooden sleeper, second one is the metal sleepers. In metal sleepers, we have steel and cast iron sleepers and the concrete sleepers. In concrete sleepers, we have the reinforced concrete sleeper as well as the pre-stressed concrete sleeper. There is actually an additional type, which is the composite. Composite sleepers, which is the combination of all the above types. The combination can be in any way. Okay. So these are the broad classification based on what? Based on the material of the sleeper. Now this, we have to study in detail what are these, why exactly they are used, advantages and disadvantages. So let's get started with the wooden sleepers. So if you can observe, these sleepers are made up of wood, right? Normally wooden sleepers satisfy almost many of the requirements of a good sleeper. And these type of sleepers are the only sleepers which have track circuiting, right? The track circuiting ability is only for wooden sleepers. No other sleepers have this type of ability. Normally, the life of wooden sleepers will depend upon many factors, like your wear, how much wear it can resist, what is the resistance towards the attack of white ants, and based on the quality of timber what we are using. Right, so based on all this, the life of the wooden sleeper will depend. The normal material of wood what we use in the wooden sleepers are sal, teak, deodar, chair wood, etc. Right, so these are the common type of wood materials what we use. When we speak about the size of the wooden sleepers, the standard size what we use, suppose we are going for a broad gauge track, then it will be 2740 mm into 250 mm into 130 mm. Right, suppose we are going for meter gauge, then it will be 1830 mm into 203 mm into the 114 mm. Right, this is the breadth. First dimension is the breadth dimension. This second dimension is the width dimension, and the third dimension is the depth dimension. Okay, breadth, width, depth, breadth or length, you can say. Moving on to the third gauge, that is your narrow gauge. So we use 1520 mm into 150 mm into 100 mm. If you observe, the length is more than the broad gauge width. So for example, in meter gauge, actually the gauge between the rails is 1 meter or 1000 mm, right? But we have to provide more sleepers on the either side, more length of sleepers on the either side. Okay. Nextly, what we have to study is the advantages of using your wooden sleepers. First one, they are easily available, right? Timber is easily available in any part of the country, right? The second one is, it is suitable for all types of ballast. Suitable for all types of ballast material which we can use, right? Third one is, they require very less fastenings. And their design is also very simple. The wooden sleeper design is also very simple. So the use of wooden sleepers will be more effective. Next is, they have very less noise in the tracks when the movement of train is happening on the tracks, right? The next one is, normally we have shocks which are coming in the tracks because of the braking or fast movement of the train, right? So these shocks and the vibrations are easily absorbed by the wooden sleeper when compared to your other material sleepers. Okay, and the last one is, they are best suited for track circuiting. That's the reason we can go for the wooden sleepers. But along with all this, we also have disadvantages of using the wooden sleepers, right? So what are the disadvantages? They have very less life when compared to other different material of sleepers what we use. And the second one is, the maintenance of gauge is very difficult in case of wooden sleepers when compared to your other type of sleepers. Then the third one is, they are affected by wear, decay, and the attack by insects and vermicides, right? So maintenance is a little difficult when compared to your wooden sleepers. Normally, the tracks which are laid on the wooden sleeper will get very easily disturbed because they are not strong enough, right? Track laid will be disturbed because of what? Less strength of the sleepers. And the final one is the maintenance cost. The maintenance cost for this type of sleeper is very, very high when compared to the other type of sleepers what we have. So these are the advantages and disadvantages of the wooden sleepers. So this was the first type. Now moving on to the next one. The next one is the metal sleepers. So usually, because of high maintenance of wooden sleepers, short life of wooden sleepers, because of these two major reasons, the metal sleepers came into existence, right? So metal sleepers have very long life, very less maintenance when compared to your wooden sleepers, right? Basically, your metal sleepers are divided into two categories. The first one is the steel sleepers, and the second one is the cast iron sleepers. Okay, these are the types of metal sleepers. Now, when we talk about the advantages and disadvantages of the metal sleepers, they can be listed as below. First of all, they have very long life of about 30 to 50 years. Right? Strength is more. And also, they have very high durability. Right, then the gauge can be easily adjusted if there is any disturbance. The gauge can be easily adjusted as well as maintained. These type of gauges will provide both lateral and longitudinal stability to the tracks. The next advantage is they are very easily and economically maintained. Basically, no much maintenance cost is required in case of your metal sleepers. Right, the next one is there will be no frequent renewal. When case of wooden sleepers, we have frequent renewals, right? So, in case of metal sleepers, we don't have to do renewals often. And the seventh point is that the scrap value of these particular type of sleepers is very high because the metal can be melted and reused. Okay. Moving on to the disadvantages. The first disadvantage is they will require more fasteners and fittings to connect them to the rails. Next, they are reliable for rust because of the rain or moisture which is available. They will require more quantity of ballast in order to keep them in position. These type of metal sleepers are not suitable if you are laying your railway track on bridges or in level crossings. They do not have track circuiting. And they cannot be used in your station yards. Suppose you have station yards, we can't use these type of sleepers there. And in case of derailment or accidents or whatever, these type of sleepers will cause more damage when compared to your wooden sleepers. Damage during derailment or accidents. So these are the advantages and disadvantages of the metal sleepers. Moving on to the types and all, you can see here. So these are your steel sleepers, these are your mild steel sleepers, and these are the cast iron sleepers. Anyways, the details of this we will study again further. So the first one is the steel sleepers. Normally these type of sleepers are made with the help of 6 mm thick steel sheets. And both the ends of this will be bent down to check the running out of the ballast. Okay. So like this, they will be bent like this at the ends so that the ballast doesn't slip out from here outside. Now at the time of pressing of sleepers, normally an inward slope of 1 in 20 on either sides is given so that the tilt for the rails is automatically given. Okay, so the standard length of these type of sleepers are 2680 mm. Now in steel sleepers, again we have types. The first type is the key type of steel sleepers, and the second one is the clip and bolt type. Now in key type, what will happen? Sleeper lung or jaws are pressed out of metal and keys are used for holding the rails here in this case. Okay, so again further two types of keys are used. Either you can use the lung type of key or you can use the loose jaw key in order to hold the rails. Okay, whereas in this your clip and bolt is used for connecting your or holding your rails. In clip and bolt type, we already provide holes so that the bolts can be fitted into this. But in key type, what will happen? We will have to press the keys into the sleeper. So there are all chances that cracks can be formed in these type of sleepers. Okay, so these are better when compared to the key type. The chip and bolt type are better when compared to the key type of sleepers. Now moving on to the advantages and disadvantages of the steel sleepers. So the first advantage is that they are very lightweight and you can easily handle these type of sleepers because of their weight. Then the second one is they will need less fastenings. Third is more life when compared to your wooden sleepers. Then the gauge will be easily maintained. Gauge can be easily maintained. Next one is the scrap value. Again, scrap value of these particular type of sleepers is very high. And they provide the lateral and longitudinal stability to the track. And finally, creep of rail is very less when in case of your steel sleepers. So these are all the advantages. Moving on to the disadvantages. The initial cost of this particular type of sleepers is very, very high when compared to your wooden sleepers, right? The second one is that if the rail sheets are not properly put, then there are all chances that cracks will develop in your sleepers. Then third one is they are not suitable for track circuiting. They are not suitable for all types of ballast. Only particular type of ballast can be used with the steel sleepers, right? Not all types. And finally, they are liable for your corrosion and rust. So these are the disadvantages of your steel sleepers. Moving on to the next type is the cast iron sleepers. These sleepers are made of the material called cast iron, and these are widely used in India. In India, the major type of sleepers what we see around are the cast iron sleepers. There are different types of cast iron sleepers. The first one is your pot or bowl sleepers. The second one is your plate sleepers. Third one is the box sleepers. The fourth one is your CST9 sleepers. And the final and the fifth one is your duplex sleepers. Now moving on to the advantages and disadvantages of these type of sleepers. Let us discuss one by one. So the life of cast iron sleepers is more even when compared to your steel sleepers. Then maintenance cost is very less. And the third one is the gauge will be easily maintained and it can be easily adjusted in these type of sleepers. Then these are more durable when compared to your steel and wooden sleepers. And finally, the creep can be checked very easily in case of your cast iron sleepers. Moving on to the disadvantages, we will need more ballast quantities if you are going for cast iron sleepers. And then the number of fasteners and fittings what we use are very high in this particular case. Then they are liable for break very easily. It can break, and again they are not suitable for all types of ballast. Only for particular type of ballast we can use them, right? So moving on to the next type. The next type is your concrete sleepers. So concrete sleepers are again of two types. One is the RCC or the reinforced concrete sleepers, and the other one is the PSC, pre-stressed concrete sleepers. Right, you can see here. So first let us discuss about the reinforced cement concrete sleepers. So basically they are made up of RCC, where steel and concrete are used together. Steel and cement are used together to make your sleepers, right? So in concrete sleepers or RCC sleepers, we have two types: through type, and the second one is the block and tie type. So the through type is also known as one piece or your mono block sleeper. The other name for it is this. The cracks will be produced in the tension zones of the concrete sleeper, but these cracks will be very small initially, but as and when the repeated loading or impact loading will occur, these cracks tend to become visible, they tend to enlarge, and that will cause the failure of the sleeper. Okay, so that is the disadvantage of using this through type of sleeper. When it comes to block and tie type of RCC sleepers, in this the blocks will be connected with the help of a metal tie of inverted section. Okay, so in this type of sleeper, they will not be subjected to any tension and there is no problem of cracks which will occur in this. Okay, so this first figure is the through type and this second figure is the block and tie type. So through, see, through and through they have gone. In block and this, here you'll have a bent like this. Okay, now moving on to the advantages and disadvantages. So the advantage is they have very, very long life, even when compared to your steel and cast iron sleepers, around 40 to 60 years. The second second advantage is that they don't have any natural decay or they are not attacked by any insects. Third advantage is they will need less fittings. Fourth advantage is your track circuiting is possible in this type of sleepers. Then the fifth one is they will have more lateral and longitudinal stability when compared to the all above type of sleepers which we have studied. Then they have very less maintenance cost. And the last one is they have very high Young's modulus or elastic modulus. And because of this, what will happen is they can take more stress when compared to all the other type of sleepers. So these are the advantages. When we speak about disadvantages, the first disadvantage is they are very heavyweight because of the concrete and the steel material which we are using. Okay, so because of the heavyweight, the handling, the transportation, and everything will become difficult. And the second disadvantage is if you are not handling them properly, there are all chances that these will get breaked more often. Okay, the third is the renewal. If there is any renewal work in these type of sleepers, it is very difficult to renew this type of sleepers. And the fourth one is the scrap value is totally nil. Nothing can be made out of after this is not in use. Okay, so scrap value is nil. This is about your reinforced concrete sleepers. Moving on to the next one is your pre-stressed concrete sleepers. So nowadays, the pre-stressed concrete sleepers are being used more extensively in Indian railways. Normally, the initial cost of these particular type of sleepers are very high. Pre-stressed is what? Initially only we will stress the concrete to its maximum, right? This need not be made on site. We will do it at a different place and then get it and put it near the place where we want. Okay. So as I told, the initial cost is very high, but on a long run, if you think about the long life of this, they become very economical and cheap. Okay. So in these sleepers, tension wires are used instead of the tension rods, and these wires will be stretched by your hydraulic jack to give a necessary tension. Then the concrete will be put under a very high initial compression. And also there are chances that whenever a derailment or accident will happen, this type of sleeper will also cause heavy damage in your structure. Okay, so those are some of the points in regards of your pre-stressed concrete structures or sleepers. Moving on to the last one is the composite type. Now in composite type, different varieties of material we will be using, composite materials. These have not yet been more used in India, but abroad they have been using this in a large quantity, right? So they may be the combination of different material what we have seen further, right? So hope this lesson is clear to you. Thank you.